to the poor. And they were haughty and committed abomination before me. Therefore, I took them away as I saw good. Amen. So we understand that it was more than just sodomy. Yeah, it was pride. But they didn't grasp verse 50. It says committed abomination. Yeah. And we know that what that abomination was. Amen. Amen. Sodomy. Amen. I want to bring something out real quick. I keep in mind, like it was brought out, and I recap that same-sex marriage is currently legal, and we brought this out in five states: Massachusetts, Connecticut, Vermont, Iowa, and New Hampshire, and in the District of Columbia. Civil unions are permitted in New Jersey. That's what that says. And now, even recently, now even Hawaii, it made it legal for civil unions. And you know, Hawaii is way too small of an island to be going against God's law. You know, all it takes is one tsunami and Hawaii is no more. All
right.
And way too small to be messing with God's natural order.
Yeah.
Amen. And keep in mind, while the world is occupied with the Middle East, which is very important, and you know, God has given me several things about that. Amen. And Lord willing. But at the same time, Obama's making his moves. Amen. You know, everybody's caught up, CNN, Libya, Egypt. But Obama's doing his thing. Like I said, he secretly defeated the Defense of Marriage Act.
Yes.
Amen. So I want to turn to the scripture real quick. And as you know, the reason why God destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah was because of sodomy and the pride. And they got too big. Amen. And God destroyed it. And we know how he destroyed it. I want to pick up in Genesis 19 and at 24. It says this: "And the Lord rained upon Sodom and upon Gomorrah brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven." Is that right? Brimstone and fire out of the Lord out of heaven. Now I want to say something about this here, because it's very interesting. Now this word brimstone is an older word for sulfur. For sulfur. Amen. And what's in a volcano, and there's many volcanoes in Hawaii. Volcanoes always erupting in Hawaii.
Mm-hmm.
If you ever watch the Discovery Channel.
Amen.
Something like that. Amen. It says, "He rained down upon Sodom and Gomorrah brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven." And when the earthquake, or not an earthquake, I want to say when a volcano explodes like it was doing in Indonesia. It was all up on the news. Even while Barack, the King of Saddam, was visiting there in Indonesia, the Indonesian earthquake kept blowing up. And keep in mind, it was raining down fire and brimstone out of heaven on the people and burning them up. That's right. Because whatever goes up has to come down.
That's right.
You got to understand what's in a volcano. What's in a volcano is fire and brimstone. Amen. Is that right? What's Amen. In a volcano is sulfur.
Yeah.
Amen. So, and a lot of times when it says out of the heavens, there's heavens could also be translated as the sky. There's three levels of heaven. And another level of heaven is just the sky. So it rained down upon the people, fire and brimstone. God's word is true. I said brimstone. What you think is in the center of the earth? Fire and brimstone. Sulfur. That's what comes out of those volcanoes. You see, so it's just a matter of time. The Bible says hell hath enlarged itself. It's just a matter of time. And how an earthquake is so closely connected to a volcano. They're very closely connected. It's just a matter of time. I think they just had an earthquake in Christchurch, New Zealand. The second largest city, I believe, in New Zealand. Christchurch. There was an earthquake. That sounds like a sign to me. Amen. It's time to get right. It's time to get right. Amen. Amen. I'm going to end with this. Hope y'all got that. Hey, y'all seem like you're a little tired today. That's all right. Me too. But God is good. Like I said, I can get the praise now. Amen. I can praise him by myself too. Amen. 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 So I wanna end with this real quick. And this is Psalm chapter 2. Amen. Say, and with everything that's happening in the world today. It says, why did the heathen rage? And the people imagine a vain thing.
Yeah.
Why did the people plot a vain thing? Amen. Even in Egypt or wherever, they riot. It's still vain because they have an antichrist spirit in Islam. You know, there might be some respect there, but ultimately it's still an antichrist religion. Amen. It says, so why did the heathen rage and the people imagine a vain thing? Why do people plot the sodomite and lesbian movement? It's a vain thing against God. It's uselessness against God. Your arms are too short to box with God.
Right.
The people imagine a vain thing.
Yes.
Amen. The kings of the earth set themselves and the rulers take counsel against the Lord, against his word, against the Lord, and against his anointed. Now, they did it back then. Amen. When they plotted and they took counsel against Jesus, the Messiah. But they're still doing it today. When they take counsel and plot against God's word with their ruler, the king of Babylon, whatever you want to call him, King Barack Hussein Obama. But it's uselessness. It's not just him, but it's other kings.
Amen.
Amen. Saying, let us break their bands asunder and cast their cords from us. But get this. It says, he that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. That's Jesus. He's laughing these demons to scorn. Hallelujah. That's what it means when it says, he who sits in the heavens shall laugh.
Amen.
He's not laughing with these enemies. He's laughing at them because he sees that their day is coming.
Yes.
Amen. And the Lord shall have them in desertion. Derision. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So let me skip down to the last verse. It says, kiss the Son. Amen. That's Jesus in this context. It means to show submission to Jesus.
Amen.
And Jesus only. Amen. It says, kiss the Son, lest he be angry, and he perish from the way, but his wrath is kindled but a little. Blessed are all they that put their trust in him, Jesus and Jesus only. Be blessed.
Wonderful remarks from all of this is to bring us into an awareness of what is taking place. They are systematically tearing down the Holy Word of God, thus to destroy the foundation of the church. When the Word is gone, you don't have any church. We have to declare and cry aloud and spare not. We're going to stand up on the battle line, on the battlefield. We're not going to take down or back down. We're not going to compromise in the slightest. And this is why sanctification and being separated people is so very important. We're going to be a separated people and stay separated. And Jesus Christ gets us out. And we're going to learn, develop more a contentment and joy in our relationship with God.
Amen.
I said before, we shouldn't have to be pumped up to make a joy for another. Let's come to church. Make it have a good time. When you get to have a good time, you're going to have a good time.
Amen.
But when you come down, amen, and you got to wait till two or three people around you start making you happy. No. Don't nobody make me happy. Because my relationship with the God of God. So again, we thank God for all this transpired tonight. And we say to the YouTube viewers again, true light is the true light.
Amen.
And you need to follow us as we follow the Word of God. Amen. We thank God for all this transpired tonight. We love Jesus. We love his word. I'm in the midst of my tongue. Thank you. Let's see. I'm going to take it down and take it back.